Now the next one in the NCERT is phenylketonuria. Remember, phenylketonuria is also a recessive autosomal disorder. Recessive why? Because there is a dominant which is the normal gene. Now why autosomal? Because 12th chromosome is the carrier of this gene. So because 12th chromosome, so it is autosomal disorder. Now phenylketonuria is also written as PKU. We have already covered this in the pleiotropy concept, if you remember. So what exactly happened in phenylketonuria is a normal human body always prepares phenyl alanine. Now this extra due to metabolism, this phenyl alanine is supposed to be modified into tyrosine. Now tyrosine, remember, this is the amino acid. So this phenylalanine is amino acid. We have already learned these things in 11th class, essential amino acid. So this amino acid undergoes changes into tyrosine, and remember, this requires the enzyme called as phenylalanine hydroxylase enzyme. Now when this enzyme is synthesized in liver, So if the gene in the liver chromosomes are not functioning, then this enzyme is not formed. If this enzyme is formed, then this will be changing into tyrosine. And tyrosine is also an amino acid, if you remember. And this amino acid is very essential for skin pigmentation to develop. So if there is accumulation, now what will happen if this enzyme is not synthesized? Phenylalanine starts accumulating in the body, and as it accumulates, it will interfere with the normal development. So there will be severe mental retardation, no skin pigmentation, no hair pigmentation. We have learned these symptoms already in the topic of pleiotropy. So the next one to study is the phenylketonuria. It's an inborn error of the metabolism, also inherited as autosomal recessive trait. The affected individual lacks the enzyme that converts the amino acid phenylalanine into tyrosine. As a result of this, phenylalanine accumulates and converted into phenylpyruvic acid and other derivatives. Accumulation of these things in the brain causes mental retardation. And it also is excreted through the urine because of its poor reabsorption by the kidney. We can do one more, which is very much similar to it. That is called as albinism. Albinism is skin pigmentation is absent. So again, it's a autosomal recessive disorder controlled by the 11th chromosome. So tyrosine. Is supposed to change into skin pigmentation. So tyrosine does not change into skin pigmentation because tyrosinase enzyme is not synthesized. So it's a similar thing, just like phenylketonuria. There is one more, which is L-captonuria. L-captonuria, this was studied by Archibald Garrard, who is called as the father of human genetics or father of biochemical genetics. Archibald Garrard. He studied this disease and gave complete description of disease. This is controlled by the gene present on the third chromosome. L-captone is synthesized in our body during metabolism. It is broken down by the oxidase enzyme to be broken down. If this enzyme is missing, this L-captone, also called as homogentisic acid, accumulates in our body and then it will affect the cartilage, tendon, joints, ligament, that means mesodermal tissue, or you can say connective tissue is disturbed. And then this also starts coming out along with the urine. So remember, the urine of a person who has L-captonuria, after standing exposed to the oxygen, or you can say exposed to the air, the urine will slowly change into black color. This is the main symptom of L-captonuria. Now, the next one explained in the NCERT is thalassemia. So, what is thalassemia? Let's understand. It's autosomal recessive disorder because chromosome numbers involved are 16th chromosome and the 11th chromosome. Now why two chromosome? Because there are two types of thalassemia. Alpha thalassemia, controlled by the two genes present on the 16th chromosome. So it is नॉन एलीलिक इंटरेक्शन और इंटरजीनिक इंटरेक्शन. टू जीन्स कंट्रोल दिस एक्सप्रेशन. एंड दिस 11th क्रोमोसोम कैरीज वन जीन, दैट मीन टू एलील्स. हेयर फोर एलील्स विल कवर इट. हेयर टू एलील्स विल कवर इट ऑन द 11th क्रोमोसोम. विच टाइप इज दैट वन? बीटा, बीटा टाइप. नाउ इट्स द सेम सिम्टम हेयर, हीमोलाइटिक anemia will be there. Now how do you distinguish these two things? Be attentive. Now in sickle cell anemia, the quality of hemoglobin is changed. In the case of thalassemia, number of the hemoglobin chains would be changed. That means in this case beta chain has been, quality has been changed. In this case, either the alpha chain is produced less or the beta chain is produced less. Accordingly, alpha type of thalassemia or beta type of thalassemia is there. That's why this is also called as qualitative change. This is called as quantitative change. Both are autosomal, one controlled by 11th chromosome, the other controlled by 16th as well as 11th chromosome. But the main thing is common hemolytic anemia. So symptoms are going to be quite same. Except RBC is not going to change into sickle shape in the case of thalassemia. Let's quickly go through this one in NCERT. It's a huge paragraph and important for your board exam. It is also an autosomal linked recessive disease transmitted in the same manner from the infected carrier to the next generation. The defect could also could be due to the either mutation or deletion, which ultimately result in reduced rate of synthesis of one of the globin chain, alpha chain or otherwise beta chain, that makes the hemoglobin. This causes the formation of abnormal hemoglobin molecule, which results into anemia, characteristic of the disease. Thalassemia is of two type, alpha thalassemia, production of alpha.